Changing the game now. Hi everybody, I'm Laurie Guest, and as a lifelong lover of board games, a recent article written by Forrester Research really grabbed my attention. It said, companies have gone from a whack-a-mole approach to playing a very different game in order to advance their customer service. And I thought, what game is it? Tell me more. But here's the thing. They never said what the new game is. So I'm left to ponder it with you. See, the article said that the reason that it's whack-a-mole is because CMOs have a habit of looking for the problems, and when they pop up, you just take the hammer and whack them back down to keep them in place. This becomes a reactive approach instead of a proactive approach. So I sat back to think about it. What is the game that has more proactive approach than any other I've ever played? And the answer is, think chess. That's right. Bobby Fischer, the most accomplished of chess grandmasters, could supposedly be 5 or 6 moves in front of his opponent. If only we could do that in business. Remember, responding is different than reacting. When you react, you create a disjointed customer experience. Forrester said that disjointed experience costs millions and lose customers, and they are the antithesis of customer obsession. Your objective should be to put the customer in the center of everything that you do. Well, it should have been our priority all along, but I don't know if that's always the case. Think travel changes that cost you money every single time, or theater tickets that you can't get a refund on, even with plenty of notice. Those are not customer service moves. Those are moves to hold the income at all cost. So for this month, we're going to break it down and take a look at 3 different approaches to play a different game with chess in mind. So here's the first. Checkmate your rewards programs. It's predicted that spending on retention marketing will increase by 30% in 2021. To meet this demand, it makes sense to adjust from the frequency-based rewards program to a highly developed loyalty program. By creating a reward program that is so desirable it leaves your buyer with no choice but to get involved, you've checkmated them. My example is my regional grocery store. They have a fuel saver card that every time I use it, I get a few cents off gasoline, which is accumulative over a month's time period. It's not uncommon for us to get a full tank of gas at the end of the month. On top of that, if you're 55 or older, you can have the senior discount. If you shop on Mondays, it's an additional 5% off. Combine that with coupons, and I'll tell you what, we have no choice but to shop at this chain because the savings in this loyalty program is so good. What does a refreshed rewards program look like in your organization? Concept number 2, find a grandmaster move. The highest title a chess player can attain is that of grandmaster, of which only 3% of all registered players hold. That means they do something different than their competitors. Well, I'm always on the lookout for professionals who do something different than their competition. And I was recently introduced to a professional photographer named John D'Amato. We have some mutual friends, and they went on and on about how amazing his talent is, which it is, and I'll tell you more about that later on in the month. But for today's video, I want to point this out. I was recently at a once-in-a-lifetime event, and I didn't think ahead to get my own photographer. But John happened to be there. He took pictures of everybody. And even though I had not employed him to do so, a few days later, in my inbox was a folder with 30 photos. 30 photos. They didn't have a watermark on them. I didn't pay anything for them. He simply gave me a note that asked me to enjoy the photos and use them in any way that I could. It's time for me to have new photos taken, and who do you think I'm calling? I'm calling the Grand Master, who had a move that is so different than any other photographer I've ever met. He's going to win the business. Can you develop a creative move that sets you apart from your competition? And finally today, I love this, avoid the Zugzwang at all cost. A Zugzwang is a German word that in chess means it's your move and all options are bad. In a business situation, it means that all the policies and procedures you put in place have left your customer with no great options. So here's a quick example. I have a 20-year-old who is very into Japanese animation. And the largest anime show that takes place in the country happens right here in Chicago, and it's called Anime Central. Well, the show was canceled, of course, in 2020, and my kid and friends had tickets to go to that one, so they were bumped to 2021. And they recently got another email that said 2021 is also being bumped, and here's the issue. They can have a credit for a ticket in 2022. They're left with no great options. Short of getting a full refund, what could Anime Central have done to make this a better experience? Well, first, they could have made the ticket available for any future shows, not just 2022. Or they could have created a special token that's only available to people who purchased tickets in 2020 and had to bump. It could become a collector's item. It would cost them very little, and those who are sitting on tickets would be excited about it instead of sad. What creative idea can you use to bump old rules that result in a happier, loyal buyer? Every time I research an article about the passion of customer service, I return to the same conclusion. Service is simple if we just stop and do the work. If we could put ourselves in the shoes of the buyer and really pause and think about how we can deliver the right experience consistently, well, the results would be amazing. In fact, it'd be a game changer.